So now let us move on to the mechanism of polymerization. Just now we have seen the types of polymerization, that is addition, condensation and copolymerization. Now by what mechanism the polymerization is taking place, that is by what chemical reaction it is carried out. So here are the three mechanism of polymerization: free radical polymerization, second one is ionic polymerization, and the last one is coordination polymerization. This ionic polymerization again divided into two types. One is cationic polymerization and anionic. But anyhow, we are not going to cover the latter two. Only the first one is there in our syllabus, that is free radical polymerization. When you hear the term free radical, what are free radicals? Are the species, odd electron species, which has no charge. It is formed through homolytic cleavage. This is a covalent bond made up of two electrons. The electrons are taken one by each of the bonded atom, and we are getting two neutral, highly reactive, odd electron species. That is your free radical, all we know. So in this free radical polymerization, the chain is carried with the help of this free radicals. Now let us move to how this free radical polymerization is carried out. So this free radical polymerization taking place through three steps. First one is initiation step, and the second one is propagation step, the third one is termination step. First let us see that initiation step. To initiate the polymerization reaction, we need certain substances, even we can say catalyst. They are called as initiators. So in the first step of our free radical polymerization, the free radicals are generated in the first step. For that we need some initiators. So here let me say I is the initiator. This initiator is undergoing thermal decomposition, giving you two free radicals. Remember, I showed earlier, free radicals are formed by the homolytic cleavage of covalent bond. Here, this initiator undergoes thermal decomposition, undergoes homolytic cleavage, giving you two free radicals. So these free radicals are going to carry out your polymerization. So this free radical is combining with the monomer. I have taken vinyl type monomer. This may be Cl. If it is Cl, then that is our vinyl chloride, which is going to give polyvinyl chloride. So this R dot free radical is going to combine with this. Before that, let me give an example for initiator. The best initiator which we are using often is our benzoyl peroxide. So this benzoyl peroxide undergoes homolytic cleavage on heating to 80 to 85 degrees Celsius, undergoes thermal decomposition, giving you the radical benzoyl radical. So let me say this is our R dot, right? Now this R dot free radical takes one electron from this double bond, that is this R is making this bond again to cleave homolytically. You know, this is a covalent bond made up of two electrons. One of the electrons of the double bond is shifted to this carbon, which is combining with R dot, and we are getting equivalent bond RCH2. Now see here, the site of free radical is on the monomer. So this is our initiation step. So this is our growing chain. So this is going to lead your polymer chain. This growing chain is going to combine large number of monomer molecules, going to give a polymer, that is in our propagation step. As far as the initiation step is concerned, this initiator undergoes homolytic cleavage to give two free radicals, and that free radical combining with the olefinic monomer, double bond containing monomer, and giving this free radical which is on the head of the monomer. Now let us move to propagation. See, in propagation, this reactive free radical is combining with large number of monomer molecules. Let me say it is combining with N molecules, N monomer units, giving you. So this is our growing chain. This is a living polymer. So here this reactive free radical combined with large number of monomers giving this growing chain, living polymer. So this propagation continues as long as all the monomers present in that vessel is used up. So once all the monomers are used, this growing chain is going to remain idle. Since why it is called as living polymer, into that, let me say I have taken certain amount of monomer, all the monomers are completely reacted off. Since there is no monomer left over, it remains idle. But still we have the reactive site. Still it is living. Into that, when you add further monomers, if you are adding some quantity of monomer into this, the reaction continues. And again, after the exhaustion of all the monomer, again it is going to remain as living polymer. So it is having the hungry for the further addition of monomers, that is called as living polymer. Right? So this living polymer, it's a growing chain, is moving to the next stage, that is our termination. So in termination, you are going to get a dead polymer. And this living polymer is converted into dead polymer through that step called termination. Let us see how it is taking place. So in termination step, there is a destruction of the free radical. So the free radical which we have here is completely destroyed by two means. One is, there are two methods we have in termination. One is coupling, other one is disproportionation. First in coupling, the two growing chain, you making use of their reactive end, they are getting destroyed themselves. Let me take two growing chains. This is one growing chain. Since I am taking two chains to differentiate it, let me take it as N1. So these two growing chains combining themselves to give a dead polymer. So these two radical sites are combining with each other and forming a covalent between them. So the now polymer is no longer living, it is a dead polymer. That is, there is no reactive end in any one of the two. So we are getting a dead polymer. So in this coupling termination, the two living radicals combines with each other and making use of the radical side, they combine to form a dead polymer. That is our coupling. Next one is disproportionation. In disproportionation, there is a hydrogen transfer from one monomer to another, one growing chain to the another. See, I'm taking two chains, two living chains. To differentiate, I have taken N1 and N2. So hydrogen atom is transferred from one growing chain into the another. Since a hydrogen atom is transferred from here to here, actually hydrogen atom is not transferred as H plus or H minus. So hydrogen is transferred from one growing chain into another as a hydrogen free radical. So let me say this hydrogen is moving as hydrogen free radical. So this carbon will get a free radical, and making use of this, we are getting an unsaturated end in one polymer. So on there in coupling reaction, two chains are combining and we got a single chain, whereas here the reaction taking place between the two chain and the reaction is transfer of hydrogen radical. So we are getting an unsaturated polymer and a saturated polymer. Since this hydrogen is transferred from here to this one, it becomes unsaturated. Since it is getting hydrogen radical, so hydrogen combines here and giving you a saturated polymer. See this end, it is saturated and this is unsaturated. So our free radical polymerization is taking place through three steps: initiation, propagation, termination. In the initiation step, free radicals are generated. In the propagation step, that free radical generated in the initiation step is utilized to give a polymer, and in termination step, the free radical is destroyed by two mechanisms and we are getting the dead polymer. So that's all about the mechanism of polymerization through free radical polymerization.